Hi, Scratchers. Mary Jo here. Now, one of the things that's most important about being able to actually go ahead and create Scratch projects is to, well, join the Scratch community. Now, you'll see up here in the upper right-hand corner, it says sign in. This is where you'll actually go ahead and log in with your username and password once you've gone ahead and joined Scratch. I have mine saved here, but I'm going to walk you through how to actually go about joining Scratch so that you too can go ahead and get started. Once you click the Join Scratch tab, it'll bring you down to three separate pages. On the first one, go ahead and choose a Scratch username and one that you'll easily remember. And make sure you do not use your real name, because on Scratch, we go ahead and we use usernames. So I'll put in Scratch Fabulous 5. That's gonna be my username. And I'll put in a password, one that's easy enough for me to remember, and hit the next button. Now there's going to be some information that Scratch asks you to provide, but it's going to be at private, so you don't have to worry about other people actually knowing what your birth month or year is, gender, your country of origin, or what your email address is. For the sake of this, I'm just going to go ahead and put in some information. I'm going to go ahead and put in an email address. And then I'm going to hit the next button. And that's going to take us to our final page, which shows you that you've gone ahead and you've joined Scratch. Excellent. Now it's already gone ahead and logged me in, and the home page is all ready for me to go ahead and start manipulating. But to show you what a really nice profile page looks like, I'm going to sign out and I'm going to go ahead and sign into the regular username that I usually use, MJM044. Okay. Now, the next thing that I'm going to talk to you about is how you actually go ahead and work with your profile. If you click the drop-down menu in the upper right-hand corner, you'll see that the first label, Profile, is right here. If you click on it, it'll take you to this page that other Scratch users also have access to. It'll show things like About Me, which you can go ahead and add or take away from. Right now, mine says, Hi, my name is Mary Jo, and I am very excited about Scratch. I'm also going to go ahead and put in welcome. Now, what about what I'm working on? Let's say that I'm working on creating a Scratch project with over 20 blocks. Just to keep other users updated on not only what you're working on, but maybe what you're interested in as well. Now, here's one of my projects. So down here, you'll notice that shared projects will show up in this category, and one will be featured right here in front of you so that Scratch users get a good concept of what you're interested in or what you've created. Down here, Favorite Projects allows you to explore and then go ahead and favor other projects that you really like. Go ahead and click on the Explore tab, and it'll take you through all different other Scratch projects that are really pretty amazing. So looking down here, Open That Chest looks really cool. So I'm going to go ahead and I'm going to favor this one by clicking on, and then that'll take me to the page where the project loads. Now so far, 664 people have favorited this project. I'm going to be the next one. And if I go back to my profile page, you'll notice down here, Favorite Projects is now in that category. Open That Chest has been added to my list of favorite projects. Now down here, we'll get to Studios in a separate module, but just to let you know, Studios will go ahead and show up in this category right here, if you are the one that curates them. If you'd like to go ahead and follow specific users, particular Scratchers that you really, really like, you can go ahead and choose to follow them. At this point, I'm not following any Scratchers yet, so I'm going to go ahead and click on the Welcoming Committee and look at some of the cool users that have popped up. If I ever want to go ahead and follow any one of them, all I have to do is click on their username and hit Follow. Now, last but not least, down here at the bottom, you can leave comments. Other users can also leave comments, but let's say that I want to go ahead and say what I've been working on today. I'm going to comment on it by saying, I've been exploring with looping blocks. Great. I post it, and now it shows up on my list of comments. If other users want to reply, all they have to do is click the reply button, and they can reply to my comment with whatever it is that they want to go ahead and say. Developing a profile is one of the best ways to get involved with the Scratch community and establish a presence for yourself on Scratch. See what you can find out there in the community and then bring it onto your page, because the best way to go about exploring Scratch is to do it with the help of other Scratchers.